Hello everyone, this is Pradeep. Welcome to this video lecture series on how to conduct online classes using Google Meet. So in the previous video, we learned how to schedule a meeting using Google Meet and what are the features a teacher needs to understand in order to have a better control to their online classes. So we had scheduled a class at 12 p.m. So if you want to look at your calendar, you need to click on Google Apps, then click on calendar. So calendar shows all the events or the schedules that you have for that particular day, or you can see it for the upcoming days as well. Since we had scheduled meeting for 12 p.m. so it is showing right here saying that so you have scheduled meeting at 12 p.m. So once you right click on this, you get all these options. So if you want to notify the organizer, since I am the organizer, I need not check in all these options. So if you are not the organizer and a meeting invite is on your calendar, you can accept the invite by clicking on this or decline the invite. Or if you are doubtful, you can click on maybe, and you can directly join the Google Meet using this option as well. Or if you are not interested in conducting this event, particular event, then you can click on delete. So if you want to change the color of this particular event, you can change it. I'll change it to yellow, okay, and I'll double click on this particular item. So if I click on this item, I get to see all these options. So it is saying that today, July 30th, I have class at 12 till 1 p.m. I can delete it, or if I want, I can email the guest as well. So in this option, you have certain options that in order to change the owner or publish the event, which we can explore it little later. So I'll click on edit event. So once I click on edit event, I get to see this window. So this is as similar to the window which we saw while scheduling the meeting. You have all these options in there as well. So one option that you do not get to see is this more actions. So if I click on more actions, I can print this particular event. I can delete it. If I click on duplicate, then the same meeting will be duplicated twice. Okay. And if I want to notify my students, I can do that as well. If I click on copy to this particular section, then this meeting link will be sent to them as well. On their meeting as well, you'll be able to see it. Okay. I'm going to double tap again and click on more actions. So this event can be published as well. Okay. So if you want to publish this event on your website, you can do that. So copy this link and you can put it up on your website. I'll just close this. And next option is, if you want to change the ownership of this event, you can do that as well by simply entering the person's email, and that person will receive the invite saying that Pradeep wants to make you the owner of this event. Would you want to do so or not? So right now I do not want anyone to be the owner of this event. So I'm clicking on cancel. So that's it for this particular video. In the next video, we shall explore more options and we shall also understand how to integrate Google Meet with Google Classroom. If you like this video, then give us a thumbs up and hit the bell icon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.